Welcome guys, and today we are going to answer one of the most searched questions on the internet. A lot of people, most people ask themselves, how can I lower the levels of cholesterol in my body? Or how do I lower the levels of cholesterol in my body? But first of all, let's understand what cholesterol is. Cholesterol is a waxy type of fat or lipid which moves throughout your body in your blood. Lipids are organic compounds that are fatty acids or their derivatives and are insoluble in water but soluble in organic solvents. Major types include fats and oils, waxes, phospholipids, and steroids. Fats are stored in form of energy and are also known as triglycerols or triglycerides. Your body makes cholesterol primarily in the liver, but can also be made by more cells in the body. It is carried around in the blood by little carriers called lipoproteins. We need small amounts of blood cholesterol because the body uses it to build the structure of the cell membranes. Cholesterol can also be obtained from the food that you eat. Cholesterol is only found in foods that come from animals. Example of these foods are milk, cheese, yogurt, cream, animal fats such as butter, ghee, margarine, and spreads made from animal fats, lard, suet, and dripping, fatty meat, and processed meat products such as sausages, egg yolks, and shrimps, and organ meats. So did you know that there are different types of cholesterol? What are these types? Let's begin with the first one, which is a high-density lipoprotein, abbreviated as HDL cholesterol. It's the main lipoprotein, and it's referred to as the good cholesterol. It absorbs cholesterol and carries it back to the liver to be flushed out of the body. High levels of HDL cholesterol can lower your risk for heart diseases and stroke. Low-density lipoproteins, abbreviated as LDL cholesterol, is one of the two main lipoproteins. LDL is often called the bad cholesterol. It is responsible for carrying cholesterol to cells that need it. Elevated LDL levels are associated with an increased risk of cardiovascular diseases and stroke. And then we have the very low density lipoproteins, abbreviated as VLDL cholesterol, are particles in the blood that carry triglycerides. Though to many people, cholesterol may seem to be an unwanted substance in our body, but it's actually essential for some important processes. For example, cholesterol helps to maintain the integrity and the fluidity of a cell membrane. It aids in production of sex hormones and builds cells. It assists in the production of digestive fluids such as bile in the liver, and also it helps in a synthesis of vitamin D. These are important functions, all dependent on the presence of cholesterol. But too much of something isn't good at all. Problems arise when you have high levels of cholesterol in your blood or in your body, especially the LDL cholesterol. High cholesterol can lead to stomach pain from fatty deposits, atherosclerosis, and an increased strain on your heart. The heart muscles may not get enough blood supply, and the heart has to work harder in order to pump blood. However, the two largest effects that high cholesterol can have on your body are the increased chance of stroke or a heart attack. You may also experience chest pain due to angina. High density lipoprotein, HDL, which is the good cholesterol, might also pick up excess cholesterol and takes it back to the liver. So the liver might find it hard to process, break down, and flush bad cholesterol. And this may cause it to accumulate and in turn lead to what we call fatty liver disease. So what can result in an increased levels of cholesterol in your blood? Unhealthy lifestyle choices such as inactivity, obesity, and unhealthy diet, which makes it preventable and treatable. Factors beyond your control might play a role too. For example, your genetic makeup might make it more difficult for your body to remove LDL cholesterol, which is the bad cholesterol, from your blood and break it down in the liver. Also, some medical conditions can cause unhealthy cholesterol levels, such as kidney disease, diabetes, HIV and AIDS, hypothyroidism, and lupus. Also, some drugs you may be taking for other health conditions, for example, drug to treat acne, for example, this drug called Accutane. Cancer drugs, high blood pressure drugs such as diuretics and beta blockers used to treat high blood pressure. HIV and AIDS drugs, a good example is protease inhibitors. Irregular heart rhythms drugs used to treat arrhythmias, a good example is amiodarone. And drugs given to tame your immune system after organ transplant, such as cyclosporine and steroids. So what are the risk factors? We had mentioned unhealthy lifestyle, which include poor diet, eating too much saturated fat or trans fats can result in unhealthy cholesterol levels. Unsaturated fats are found in fatty cuts of meat and full fat dairy products. Trans fats are often found in packaged snacks or dessert. Being sedentary, lack of exercise. Exercise helps boost your HDL, the good cholesterol. Obesity, a BMI of 30 or more puts you at a risk of high cholesterol levels. Smoking may lower your blood levels of HDL cholesterol. Alcohol drinking. Drinking too much alcohol can increase your total cholesterol level. Age. Though it can also occur in young children, the risk increases more with the age of 40 years and above. As you age, the liver becomes less able to remove LDL cholesterol. There are no particular symptoms, but visiting a doctor to check your lipid profile will be an appropriate thing to do. A lipid profile typically measures triglycerides. We had mentioned that triglycerides earlier. It's a type of fat in the blood. High triglycerides also increase your risk of heart diseases. Cholesterol screening. According to the National Heart, Lung and Bladder Institute, NHLBI, first cholesterol screening should occur between the ages of 9 and 11 years and then followed or then be repeated 5 years after that. It also recommends that cholesterol screening should occur every 1 to 2 years for men of ages 45 to 65 and for women of ages 55 to 65. People over the age of 65 should receive cholesterol test annually. More frequent measurements may be suggested by the doctor if you have a family history of cholesterol or heart diseases or other risk factors such as diabetes or high blood pressure. Now let's get into the main title of this presentation. How do I lower the levels of cholesterol in my body? Exercise and diet. These two go in hand. Getting more physical activity and losing weight may help. Exercise for 30 minutes, 4 times, if not all days of the week, in an exercise that you enjoy. This will suffice or will help. Cut on the amount of animal fats, saturated fats and trans fats, and use good fats in moderation. Increase your intake of omega-3 and fiber. Eat low-salt diet. 60% of your meals should compose of fruits and vegetables. Whole grains too, they are rich in fiber, which I had mentioned earlier. Smoking. It's advisable to quit smoking and limit your alcohol consumption. You might even try fasting. It will help you lose some weight. And also manage your stress. You might also get a prescription from a doctor. These drugs called statins that help reduce levels of cholesterol in your body. Most of these things are modifiable, so you can just strive to follow the advice that I gave. And if things don't go well, please ensure to check up with your doctor. That is it for now. Stay happy and stay safe. Until next time, let me meet you in the next one.